From Cape Canaveral in Florida, this is Atlas Launch Control at T-minus 2 hours and holding. We're now just 2.5 hours away from the liftoff of NASA's TDRS-K tracking and data relay satellite. Launches atop a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket from Launch Complex 41 at Cape Canaveral. The launch window today extends from 8:48 to 9:28 p.m. The launch window tonight is 40 minutes in duration. This will be the 35th Atlas V rocket to be launched from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. The TDRS-K tracking and data relay satellite will relay voice, data, and telemetry communications between spacecraft in Earth orbit and ground controllers. This includes the International Space Station, the Hubble Space Telescope, and scientific satellites. Even the Atlas rocket being launched tonight with TDRS-K will be tracked using the TDRS system in orbit, taking over from the ground tracking stations of the Eastern Range, beginning about 6.5 minutes into the flight. 10 tracking and data relay satellites have been launched since the first one launched on the space shuttle on April 4, 1983, almost exactly 30 years ago. The TDRS system allows almost constant space communication. Because of the reliability and longevity of the system, TDRS-K is the first one to be launched by NASA that the agency has needed since 2002, over 10 years ago. The spacecraft was built for NASA by Boeing Space Systems. So at this time, we're awaiting our poll from the NASA launch director, Tim Dunn, of the NASA team, and that will be followed by the poll of the Atlas team to begin tanking of the Atlas V rocket with cryogenic propellants. At T-minus 2 hours and holding, with 6 minutes remaining this planned built-in hold, this is Atlas Launch Control.